Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater is being remade, guys! Oh glory, glory, hallelujah. But don't get too excited just yet. Konami is definitely remaking Metal Gear Solid 3, essentially for a pachinko machine. What the hell, Konami? This is basically Konami pulling down their pants and bending over every single Metal Gear Solid fan out there. Konami has released a brand spankin' new promo video showing off its Metal Gear Solid 3 scenes that have completely been redone and rebuilt from the ground up with the Fox engine. It's leaving many fans wondering why. Why would you not remake Metal Gear Solid 3 for consoles? Why would you do this to the fanbase that loves your games? I mean, it's not really the first time that Konami has given fans the middle finger. You don't even really need to look that far back, just look at Silent Hill and what has happened with that. Fans just feel quite burned by the company they once loved. The pachinko game is going to have many mini-games that revolve around many moments from the game, including an ocelot fight and a virtuous mission. Sure, a pachinko machine is very, very big in Japan, but here stateside it's not popular at all. This overall feels like very cruel marketing on Konami's part, as it definitely is a big slap in the face to so many fans who love the Metal Gear Solid games. You don't just build a fan base years and years on your series and then out of nowhere just do this. However, there could possibly be some light at the end of the tunnel. But this is a very, very big maybe. Some people do believe that Konami would not go through the trouble of making all these new scenes completely redone in the Fox engine if there was no more purpose for them. Like maybe it's being used for more than just meets the eye. Some believe this could be a teaser for things to come. However, others believe that Konami could have been working on a remake, but then stopped and canceled the project, and that they decided to put all the leftover assets into this pachinko game. Either way, at the moment, it has fans really pissed off. I'm very pissed off. I have lots of love for Metal Gear Solid since the very first PlayStation 1 release, and I've played the hell out of the series ever since then. Now, the flip of the coin is that Konami is a business and they're gonna run their company as such. Konami is doing horrible with what they are changing in their gaming division, but as a company, they are actually doing really well. Pachinko machines are actually really big in Japan, huge enough that Konami is making bank. Konami is actually doing really well for themselves, and ultimately, it is a dick move, but they are a company and their bottom line is to make money, not fans. Do I think this is wrong? Yes, I do. But is it going to change anything by being mad? Probably not. I am more sad than anything to see the state of Konami and all the franchises and the games that I love. Everything just seems flushed down the drain to me. Sure, some are still making profit for Konami, but for the fans, it's just heartache and anger. As a gaming company, I think Konami is pretty much done for. Yes, they do say that they are not done with Silent Hill and they're certainly not done with Metal Gear Solid, but if it's just pachinko machines that they have in mind, I don't want any part of it. I hope they use whatever assets that they made for the pachinko machine on Metal Gear Solid 3, and they put it towards good use in a faithful remake. I believe it is a very long shot since we are honestly dealing with Konami here, and they haven't really been doing things in favor of the fans in years. Konami as a whole company just kind of sucks to me. Sure, it is a business and business's bottom line is to make money, but it's a company full of assholes. Look at how they treat all their creators. Look at how they treat the fans, their legacy, their attitudes are piss poor. They certainly have a lack of respect, and in turn, a lot of fans have lost a lot of respect for them. I think sooner or later though, Konami can come back to gaming. That's my hope at least. I don't like the company, but I absolutely love some of their franchises and I don't want to see them die. Sure, there is absolutely a lot of hate for Konami and I can absolutely understand that. I just don't want to see those franchises die off. I would absolutely love to see Konami sell off the rights to those games and have someone competent take over the reins, but that's not gonna happen. Those two franchises are still very much money-printing machines. Can Konami redeem itself? I'm not sure, but I want it to. I want to see a Snake Eater remake. I want a new Silent Hill game. I want the Konami from years ago back. Eventually, pachinko is going to die out. Not everything lasts forever. Konami at one point will quit making bank on these machines, and their strategy is going to have to change. Does this mean they're going to return to consoles? Not necessarily, because they have also said that they have money in mobile gaming. So maybe not. I don't know what the future is for Konami, but what I do know is this. Konami needs to change its attitude. I don't know if that means maybe some interchanges with the people inside the company, but something definitely has to change if Konami wants to get back into gaming. For now though, they seem pretty content on just making money with pachinko. It sucks, but I can't blame them, as money makes the heart of a company. But Jensen, wait! There's a Metal Gear Solid zombie game! Ugh. To me, that's just some generic action survival zombie game with the Metal Gear name slapped onto it. Because without the Metal Gear Solid name on it, it probably would not sell as much because it looks really generic to me. The game looks bizarre and just out of place for what it is. And yes, I do know that Metal Gear Solid is known to be bizarre, but this is just really far out of the realm. But Jensen, what about Metal Gear Rising? Well, Metal Gear Rising wasn't really a part of the series in any kind of way. It was meant to survive on its own foundation. And yes, this zombie game could very well be just like that. The franchise actually has many spin-offs, including a strategy card game, so it's not really new to have a different experience inside of that. But a lot of those games had a well-crafted story and added a lot to the lore of Metal Gear. Maybe I'm honestly just not giving Metal Gear Survive a fair shake, since Konami is full of dicks. Maybe I have biased eyes in the situation. Maybe it just looks generic and unnecessary. Does a four-player Metal Gear Solid game sound cool? Perhaps, but meh. Anyways, I just wanted to talk about the news of the pachinko machine, and I hope I really got my point across. I would really love for something else to come out besides this pachinko machine, but deep down, I know it's not gonna happen. I wish Konami was different, but at the end of the day, a company is going to do what a company does best, and that's make money, and that's the bottom line. I can't fault them on that, but there is a lot of other things I can fault them on. But that's gonna be it, guys. If you like these videos and want to see more like this, go ahead and like, comment, and share this video. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys. You guys have a good day and a good night.